Okay, I'm just trying to help out a fellow YouTuber here. His channel name is The Corvette Ben, all one word. And he has a 56 Cadillac. So anyways, this kind of hits close to home because I was kind of having some transmission problems as well. I'd like to kind of help him out here. So this is a video to kind of help him out and get to the bottom of this. The problem being is there's not many of these old timers around that really fully understand. Hear that whine right there? Just at a cold idle, it's whining.
Alright, the wheel chock's gone.
Okay.
That might be helpful.
So yeah, he's trying to diagnose a problem here. This whining, squealing.
It's much better than it used to.
He's all the way down in Texas.
All through reverse. Which is consistent. Let's put it in dry. Let's squeal up through first into second. Hopefully you guys can hear it. So I'll start from my neighbor.
So it's really noticeable.
It's going off through first. Leave it, goes in second, and then once it pops in the third, it squeals again. So now it should be in fourth.
Yeah, that's in direct drive, so. Direct drive, there's no noticeable sound. I think I hear it a little bit in second, but it's not that bad. So I'm just munching away on some of these leftover pumpkin seeds from Halloween. But anyways, got me thinking here, and I was just trying to check this out in my book. This book is kind of like, you know, the 1956 shop manual for these actual specific cars, and I bought this a long time ago when I got my car. Anyways, just this from here to here is on the operation and theory of the actual hydromatic transmission. Now, the right terminology is crucial when you're trying to understand these transmissions. I'll be the first to admit I don't really understand 100% of this, but I do know the basics, and I do think that the metal filings that he found in the bottom of his transmission were a result of maybe the incorrect reassembly of these planetary gears. Now, what leads me to think that is I kind of put a bookmark right here. This is very helpful, this book and everything. It tells you, you know, how it works, kind of deal, the theory of the operation, how, what the parts are called, how to take it apart, what tools are required to take it all apart. Now, I mean, after having, you know, this thing, I'd be tempted to, you know, when mine was having some problems, I'd be tempted to take it apart, but the problem being is I don't really understand how like what I'm looking for exactly that would be wrong with it, and I think that's part of the problem with a lot of these people is the old timers that know these transmissions inside and out know exactly what they're looking for, and would know what is a good part and what is a junk part, and what kind of supplier to use, because I'm sure that, you know, there's eBay garbage that would not hold up to, you know, these all-American transmissions. This transmission, you could actually bump start it if you needed to. You could push it and then it would actually start the engine. And this is the result of the torus converter. It's not actually a torque converter, it's a torus converter. Back then, they were called a torus converter for this transmission. Basically, if you read this and go through each one of the gears, the planetaries are right the front planetaries, I do believe, is that part up there. And the reason there's no noise in fourth gear is because it's just basically a direct flow. It's only engaging at the back, and that's it. All the front operation is closed or whatever. But what leads me... Okay, where did I put that paper? Right there. Okay. So, test for hydromatic noises. So, I'm just going to hold this over here, and maybe you can read that. But from, you know, first and third speeds in an R may be caused by the front planetary gears. So, that would explain if there was something wrong with those, it would be making those noises. And then... it's all the linkage adjustment and stuff like that. So, I don't know if, you know, if that's helpful at all or whatever, but there's not many guys that actually know how and what they're looking for and how to put these back. They're kind of an obsolete thing. I know that... of one place locally, and there's only one place locally that actually knows how to rebuild one of these that I would feel confident sending it to them to get repaired. But I mean, that's just the thing, though, is a lot of these old guys are retired, or, you know, they don't work on them anymore. What really sucks is the removal of the transmission. That's kind of a big job, but gotta do what you gotta do. So, yeah, there's all the tools that are required and everything. And somebody used this book and whatnot, and it's all checked off what tools they had and didn't have. But for something so simple, it is actually a pretty complex transmission. But the ones nowadays are even more complex with the, you know, the circuitry and all the electronics that can fail. So, yeah, I don't know. The other thing was possibly an oil pump was going bad on it. Now, these transmissions actually have two oil pumps. But basically, you know, you'd have to talk to somebody that knows exactly, you know, these transmissions inside and out. And it's good of you not just jumping into this. And, you know, I know there's a lot of keyboard ninjas that think they know what they're talking about, but really don't have any life experience to back that up. So I'd be kind of hesitant to, you know, kind of jump into anything. But anyways, Ben, I hope that is somewhat helpful for you. And, you know, basically I put my Cadillac away just before the snow last night. It just barely fit in this garage here. Oh man, you know, I got barely enough room here to squeak by and barely enough to get around to the toolbox over there. So I don't know what to say, Ben, but I hope you figured it out. And I know that I had to buy a whole nother car just to get the transmission, and there was no guarantees that it was even going to work. Something I'm looking for mine, if anybody can keep an eye out, I would like to, you know, for this family sedan, I'm kind of looking for another seatbelt that's like this style. If it has, if it's not exactly the same, that's okay, but I'm looking for something from a GM car, you know, this style. If anybody has that, you know, it doesn't have to match exactly, but let me know if anybody knows where to get those. Use, of course, so they'll match up.